Bank intent on wringing every last dollar from its victims at any cost. Instead of helping immigrants with loans, they are actively defrauding them and their descendants with overpriced mortgages. They have used these predatory lending practices to push their customers into risky mortgages that they knew would eventually break them. They have also preyed upon minority applicants by intentionally steering them into more expensive mortgages even when they qualify for lower priced mortgages. They just spent $250 million to pay off the government for that. B of A then joined their Wall Street buddies and bundled these mortgages into a deceptive financial instruments, a process which helped blow a $17 trillion hole, $1,700 trillion hole in our economy and cause the Great Recession.
Depression.
We are, now I'd like to lay some facts on you. We are here to gather here to mourn the fact that 1 in 5 American homes are currently underwater. We are gathered here to testify that Bank of America has paid off the mortgages of customers whose stories posed too serious a media threat to the bank's reputation, only on the condition that the customer agreed to remove all public traces of the bank's wrongdoing. We are gathered here to mourn the fact that Wall Street and the banks like B of A were given over $7 trillion to fix their gambling problem, but all of these parties cry socialism when anyone suggests helping out American homeowners.
Yeah. That's right.
We are gathered here to mourn the fact that as we speak, banks like this behind me are in negotiations with your government to gather up all of these foreclosed homes and rent them back to the very same Americans that were just kicked out.
Bastards.
I can find no better supporter of these facts than President Obama himself. The President has just created a new mortgage fraud unit led by the U.S. Attorney General to investigate the transgressions of lenders like Bank of America.
That's right.
So whether you take these issues to heart or not, the supreme leader of our land considers them worthy of review. Mr. President, Occupy asks you to make good on your words to help the American homeowner.
Yeah.
Do not give in to the moneyed interests that seek to whitewash these crimes of greed. Demand justice for the American homeowner.
Yeah.
Brothers and sisters, all is not lost. With the trial of death comes the hopes of resurrection, the hope that we can make things better. It is in this spirit of resurrection that is fueling the rebirth of activism all over Texas and all over the country. Brothers and sisters, what can we do?
Fight back.
Occupy.
Yes.
Occupy.
Keep the message alive. The entities guilty of all these offenses want everyone to forget about their victims. They want them to be cleared from the market. Tell your elected representatives, tell your friends, tell your preacher, tell your mailman, tell everybody that this will not stand. Tell yourself that I'm going to talk to 3 people today or this week about this injustice.
Yeah.
Hey.
If you know someone who is underwater on their home, have them contact the Neighborhood Assistance Corporation of America.
Yeah.
They are an excellent outfit. We have people who work there who can help you out. Please contact them. If you need a lawyer to help with your fight, contact the Dallas Volunteer Attorney Program. They will talk to you for free. Register and vote.
Yeah.
Thousands of people around the globe have recently given their lives for the right to vote. Please register to vote in the coming elections.
Yeah.
Volunteer to drive people to the polling places. Volunteer to knock on doors to register people. Volunteer. This could be the last free election that you all see for many, many years to come. Get educated. Learn about the facts. Learn about the propaganda. And learn how to distinguish between the two.
Yeah.
Right.
Get involved. Commit to your favorite activist group.
Yeah.
Whoever it is.
Yeah.
However their role.
Yeah.
Your contribution counts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Amen.
move your money out of these banks.
Oh,
yeah. Right, you're right.
5.6 million Americans have moved their money out of these banks in the last 90 days.
Yeah.
Right. Credit union. Use the power of your labor of social media to spread our message and steer public opinion in a rational direction. Get online. Tell your friends what's up.
Yeah.
Is that in songs?
It's in the Book of Evictions right there.
And finally, I want to thank everybody here today for coming out. On behalf of Occupy Dallas, I would like to thank North DFW 99%.
Yeah.
Occupy Now.
Yeah.
Occupy North Texas.
Yeah.
MoveOn.org.
Yeah.
Code Pink.
Yeah.
The Dallas Peace Center.
Yeah.
Iranians for Peace.
Yeah.
Pax Christi.
Yeah.
Veterans for Peace.
Yeah.
And Occupy Dallas. Yeah. Jobs for justice.
Occupy Tyler.
Occupy everybody everywhere.
I leave you all with two things: a question and a call. What are you going to do to restore the American dream? And the call is: don't let the dream die. Occupy.
Occupy. Occupy!
There will be a picnic at the park down the street. Don't let the dream die! Occupy! There will be a picnic down the street at Morris Park on the left. On the right.
Don't let the dream die.
And then during the picnic at 3:30, there will be the anti-war rally for no war in Iran.
Hey!
Hey! One last thing. The last Occupy camp in Washington, D.C. is just being plowed under today.
Oh, shit.
And I want you all to just think about the fact that even though these camps get plowed down, Occupy is not done. We're not done by any means.
That's right.
So we will reoccupy, we will retake the streets, we will we will not let this stand.
We need
raw men, preacher, raw men. Raw men.
Mike check.
We need the pow. We need the pow bears.
Pow bears.
Pow bears.
Are you going to march back?
Yeah, I actually.
Welcome back to the wall.